little bit lost here. Okay, this is the 24th of April. Supposed to hit up in the high 40s today. The sun is shining. And this is the Sheridan River. Now, I knew there was a trail going in here because people come down here to cut driftwood for their fireplaces and stoves and so forth. But I don't know how far it goes. Last weekend, my buddy Jim from the Brooknecks Channel took him and his wife Robin, and they went down there and they said they got a couple miles. So I love exploring. I'm going to go see how far I can get. Yeah, head off the highway here. The trail goes over this way. I'm just kind of following tracks and I don't know where they go. Some good wood there. This is about the only time of the year you can get in here because the water comes up fast. Getting a little rocky bottom here. Hard to follow the tracks in some spots. still going. A lot of moose tracks down here. I think I'm heading over towards the main channel. You can see by them cut down banks over there where it's been running fast in there. Ducks over there. No tracks. Big pile of driftwood. There. Okay, I can see some tracks here. Look at these stumps. Somebody came all the way down here to cut wood. No tracks that way, little track that way. Thank you. lot of tracks on the ground here. A lot of them look like seagull tracks. There's some more ducks flying around over there. Run out of four-wheeler tracks. There are some moose tracks. There are some geese. I think I'm running out of trail here. Yeah. Getting boggy down there and a lot of driftwood. That's a beaver tree. See where he's gnawed that whole thing down. And that is a big beaver dam down there. Maybe I can get a little closer. No, I'm not going to get out a little closer. I'm going to get out of here. Got my ass right up against a stump here. Keeps wanting to go sideways. Okay, I'm gonna have to cut some brush here. GoPro, stop recording. Okay. Stomp some brush under there. Working up a sweat here. Get the wheel straightened up a little bit. Got the diff lock engaged. I don't want to spin too much because just digging a hole. Not working. Let's see if I stomp that a little further down. Go. Whew. Okay. I don't like doing it this way, but put the cable around that stump. Try winching myself backwards. That's not working. All I'm doing is pulling the front end off the ground. So, I got one more game to play. I don't like to do this, but got no choice. Well, things didn't work out quite like I planned. Tried winching off that stump there. And all it did was pull the front end up and the back end down, coming over the top. Tried rejiggering the cable, get a more direct pull. That didn't work. Tried stuffing a bunch of branches underneath it. No go there either. So, I've gone to the plan that I don't like to go to. Trying to see out here, and got a fire going, making some smoke. I called Jim up. He is eager to take time off from work. I mean, face it, you get a choice of working in a tire shop or going for a trail ride. Which would you do? So now I got to wait on him. And since he don't know where I'm at, just kind of general direction, I might have to fire off a few flares. Well, while I'm waiting for Jim, where's that's what I was trying to get a picture of. That is a humongous, huge beaver house. That's probably the biggest one I've seen. Well, fortunately, I got plenty of water with me, and I didn't bring any trail bars this time for some reason. But that's life.
Yes,
I is. So Jim finally got here and his winch is busted.
But that's okay.
So we're gonna hook up the tow rope and jerk it.
You've seen my built-in tow rope, right?
Your what do you call it, a tiger thing?
Tiger tail. Yep. All right. Well, let me get.
But you're not gonna hook onto that, are you?
Huh?
The tiger tail is pretty long. I don't think you got enough room.
Let me see. It's not that long. It's not as long as you think.
Okay.
We'll see.
Maybe I do. Get my sleeve up so I don't get too much mud on me.
Hold on. Wait.
Oh, here, this is the stuff I was trying to stuff under the wheels.
Right. Let's see how far in I can go.
It's...
Yeah, it's pretty soupy.
You gotta go down in the water.
I got it right here, my finger's on it.
Huh?
My finger was on it.
Got it?
Keep that tight.
Okay, let me get in here. Okay. Okay. Jerk it again. It's going. It's moving. Okay. Another successful mission.
Yes.
It ain't often you get a Can-Am to pull a Honda.
Brooknecks ride of 2024.
Well, you can thank me later. Like I said earlier in the video, you know, you got a choice of staying in a shop and changing tires or coming out for a ride.
Right.
It ain't no brainer. And it's kind of this shit, you know, that I keep the fire starting kit and everything in a box. And okay, everybody had to take a water and whiz break.
I'll follow you.
Well, Jim wants to follow me. Throwing mud in the air here. Now Jim tells me that spot where I got stuck is where he stopped the other day. So now I know why. Bunch of fur on the ground there. Something got a moose. I don't think I came in that way. Wanna go over that way? area. Now I see tracks. Yeah, Jim said the water's up a little more than when he was in here. We're a little bit lost here, which doesn't really mean much, because if we're heading towards the mountains, we're heading towards the road. On the track. There's the highway up ahead. The Sheridan River Bridge. Thank you. through the driftwood. Some big stuff coming down here. And back to the old bus. I gotta buy Jim a donut or something when we get back to town. And thank you all for coming along.